Welcome back to Let's Play Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. Blind, I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now leaving Haruku. Have to go to the other side to deliver a letter. Just gonna look at the map, but that's not it. Okay. Calak's letter calling truce with his brother. So I have to deliver that. To Haizen, I guess? Yeah, I guess we're going to Haizen. We'll fight this thing. Whatever the hell that is. Oh, those dragon things. I remember those. Chris has got a finishing move she can use. We'll do it on this cracking egg thing. You would think the dragon would be the most powerful thing, but in the past, they haven't been. Karameg, yeah, it's casting fireball. 40 points, wow. Whoa! Excuse me, guys. The mango lime kombucha stuck in my throat there for a minute. Alright, so we got rid of the egg thingy. Let's finish off the boar. Well, Chris can fight this thing, it's right there. The rest of us fight these boars. You out. Water. So we got fire and water. These things just take a licking and just keep on ticking. Look at all those points. We're getting super experience here, and 72 gold, that's not bad. Be good if we have something to buy it with. Last time all we found was a new sword for Yurio, which is good. Alright, so Philly will help out, some magic assistance. How about the... Okay. Same thing, except less, wild boars. This Philly's finishing move on the cracking egg goop thing. They always go first to those things. How could a cracking egg be so fast? There's no choice but to finish cracking the egg. It's still kicking. Water ball. Finish it. Thank you. That's awesome. We got a mind potion and a cure potion. I think our cure is... Actually, no. I think we have some cure we didn't use. Yeah. We still got mind potion. Yeah, we can still use some of that, too. Speaking of which... I notice we have to heal after every battle now. We don't have to, but it's a good idea. Alright, so we're going this way. Oh. Philly says, Yurio. There's a road up ahead that goes north from here. That road leads just south of my house. It's a rough path, but you can get to Haizen that way. Yurio says, I didn't know you lived so close. Chris says, then we should have gone this way to begin with. Hey, Philly, isn't this path a lot shorter? It's a rough path. I didn't think it was a very good idea to show you this path. That was it. I wanted to be with Yurio as long as I could. Aww. Yurio, why are you getting red? Chris says. Huh? What? We don't have much time. We should get going. Aww. That's adorable. Hungry yet? Ah, rumbling from hunger. Well, let's give you something. Some choice food here. I'm gonna give you angel food. Oh, you found something immediately. Oh, we don't need that. So, wait, we're supposed to be going south or north, or can we only go south? I'm confused. Alright, looks like we can only go north. So just out of curiosity, what the heck is down here? Besides full cure potions that we don't need. Chris says, we need to get to Haizen and see King Eneton. Philly says, take the north road. Okay. Look like we could go there. The wild path. It splits up, though. Riz's house. Looks like it only goes to Riz's house. Oh, this is the rough path she was talking about. Oops. It joins back together again. Okay. But I don't want her to leave. She's his new girlfriend. Hi. Sniff, sniff, says Bang Bang. Are you a good boy? Says Philly. Can't answer you, it doesn't speak. Oh, Philly, welcome back. Looks like we were able to make the potion. Yes, Mother. The Algras were still in the forest. That's good. It's probably because the people of Udor took really good care of the forest. Hello, my name is Chris. I'm the one who was cursed. Philly really helped me. Thank you very much for your hospitality. What a well-mannered young lady. I'm glad you're okay. You can stay here as long as you like. But Mom, she can't. Is something wrong? She's on her way to deliver a letter to the King of Haizen by request of the King of Haruku. Really? Such an important task? Well then, you must be on your way. As always, be careful. Yes, Mother. Hurry and be on your way. Be sure not to wander around. Sad farewells coming, I suppose. I want the... You know, she has good healing powers anyway. I want her to stay with the... with everybody. Well, we know it's north to Haizen. We've been here before. Bling. Wait, she's still with us? I thought she was gonna stop off at home. Oh, I didn't mean to hit that. I'll fight you. Sorry, I was busy looking at signs over and over again. So the question's gonna come up from Chris, I'm sure. Weren't you staying at your house and we were going on? Alright, so Yo-Yo's gonna do finishing move on the bear, and that's not even gonna finish it off, so Chris will follow up with an attack. And Philly will just attack anyone. She'll probably go before Chris, actually. Maybe he'll be able to finish it off. He's leveled up a couple times. Oh yeah, there we go. Here come the commando birds. Miss. Let's get the copper crab. You missed with your pokes. All hitting different ones. Damn. It knocked her down. I didn't even see where she went. Vicious food and a cure potion again. I think we're full of cure potions now. No, we have 8. Okay. Speaking of curing, I am really surprised she's still with us. I thought that was the whole point of it. We were dropping her off home kind of thing, and she was coming halfway with us. I sense a conversation coming up. Finishing move on the killer bear. This will take care of him. Missed. Didn't miss. All right, you better go help her out. There we go. Chris levels up. Level 24. We got some diet food. The bunny would really hate that. What does diet food even do? Oh, wind-based attacks. You're not hungry, are you? I'll give you some... Wait. I hit the wrong thing. Sometimes it gets hungry, like, soon after. Well, I guess. Light cactus. Birds moving up. Hopefully this finishes it off. Awesome. One-shotted the bird. rid of the other bird. Getting a lot of XP from these things. It's got the most magic. Chris does. Okay. Quick save. Haizen, the capital of Fenty. We're here already. Nice. Oh, it's fine. I don't need that, you little stinker. Well, we got here pretty quickly. Now, this is interesting because I had a feeling that the castle was going to be more fleshed out because when we were there, there's like nothing going on. It's like, what's the point of this place? And yeah, now there's going to be stuff to see in there. But we'll go around and talk to everyone again and see if they have anything new to say. Don't need that either. Hi, Philly. You're cute, as always. Oh. The king is always worried about something, but it looks like he's really worried this time. T-Man is saying. Can you go visit him? I think he'll feel better if he sees you. I don't think there's anyone in here. It's a pretty small town. Lada says, I must clean the stage thoroughly because it will be used for empty casks. Why don't you sing for us the next time, Philly? Me? No, I'm embarrassed. Yeah, she insists. I read that before. Yeah, this is the same stuff. Does he sell things? I guess not. This tavern serves very good liquor, but you kids mustn't drink alcohol. We won't serve minors. Good for nothing. You're such a good girl to come check on me so often. You'd make a good wife someday. I don't remember her saying that. Yo-Yo's wife. Hee! Hippo says, I hear empty casks are drawing crowd in the tavern. What are empty casks? These are casks that are empty, but why would they be drawing a crowd? Oh, Philly, be happy. The bandits are gone. It's because of all of our patrols. They probably got scared and ran off. The bandits are no match for us, the Fenty soldiers. Ha 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 ha. Okay. I don't know what you've been smoking, but give me some. Rietta says, Grandma's looking better. Your medicine is really great, Philly. You do not deserve a response from Philly. Oh, hi, Philly. The medicine you gave me worked well. I'm all better now. Philly, let's go for a walk together once I get better, okay? You don't deserve a response either. Yeah, I'm assuming the same stuff. Staff of Light. Yeah, this is all stuff that we do not need. Philly, you're always so cute. Hello, Colt. Thank you for always guarding the village. There are no problems in the village. The bandits have left the area. Haizen is peaceful right now. I don't want your pet food. Oh, I talked to him already. That might be all the... Did we go in here? Oh, she sells pet food too, doesn't she? Yeah, I don't need that. Alright, let's go on to the castle. Hi, Philly. Are you with your friends today? No, she's with her friends today. Hello, Philly. You're cute as usual. Aw. No one's, like, flirting with her. Reverie says, it's the best for brothers to have a good relationship. They should work together to rule Fenty. King Eneton's ideals haven't changed, but if they don't talk to each other, they start doubting one another. Yeah, definitely didn't hear that before. Interesting. Yeah, the chests aren't anything. At least they weren't when we were here before. Yeah, nothing. I just want to look all around before we go see the king. Yeah, he said that before. Hey, Philly, you're always so energetic. That's a new one. Energetic. Alright. I didn't think we could even go up here before, could we? These are like suits of armor. You cannot interact with them. Look at all these chests. I must open them. So cruel. All these empty rooms, though. King Eneton is always worried about something. I don't know what he's so worried about, but it seems like it's his hobby to be worried about something. Is that so? His hobby. We got books! Yay! Elder Karis says, I remember a book with the witch's prophecies inside. Did you read it? It seems like the Moonlight Witch foresaw all this a long time ago. Alright, we gotta see what these books are. There's a book that reads, On the Shores of Lake Rapinas, on its spine. Yurio takes the book in his hands and opens it. On the Shores of Lake Rapinas. Fenty, which lies along the shores of Lake Lupinas, is divided into two areas, the north and the south. The north is governed by King Eneton, while the south is ruled by his younger brother, Calak. Originally, Haizen in the north was the only capital, but the king divided the country at the births of his twin princes. A mansion was built in Huruku. The king wished that the two princes would build a new nation. Thus the twin capitals of Haruko and Haizen were born. The king wished that his sons would build a better country together. The brothers developed a rivalry in the building of the country, competing in just about everything. Probably out of grief over a sibling rivalry, a traveling witch left these words, "Mother divides blood not to divide the country." They sound a word of caution for the future of Finthy. Yuria says, "It's too difficult for me to understand." Oh, brother. It's not hard to understand, Yuria. One of the books reads, "The mysterious wildcat on its spine." It looks like a children's book. Yuria takes the book in his hands and opens it. The Wildcat Bandits. That what it was called? The wildcat is our hero. He appears from the woods like the wind and helps us whenever we're in trouble. The grown-ups call him a bandit, but the wildcat is a nice person. When I was attacked by a bear, he appeared out of nowhere and saved me. I'd love to see the mysterious wildcat again. Yuria says, "This is too childish, but I like the name Wildcat. It sounds sleek." "Do you think so?" says Chris. So here they call it the Mysterious Wildcat, and here it's called the Wildcat Bandits. Whatever. To me it sounds like one bandit, but okay. Yeah, I want to see the king last. Oh, it's like a balcony. Oh, I guess the king's in there then. I think we came up here then, this way? Yeah. Oh, we can't go any further, okay. He's worried about something again. Hi, Philly. The king is troubled again. Can you go and make him feel better? What's over this way, then? Nothing. Another chest we can't open. Very cruel, indeed. Okay, sliding over. Oh, hello, Philly. You're here with friends today. You look unhappy, King Eneton. Yeah, actually, I am. Chris says, you're worried about South Finthy's king, King Calak, aren't you? How did you know? Yuria says, we were at Haruku. Here's a personal letter from him. Yuria handed over Calak's letter. King Eneton opened the letter and read through the personal letter from King Calak, nodding many times. I see. That's the reason. I was concerned because all contact from Calak stopped and all the roads leading to Haruku were shut down. And then there's the Moonlight Witch's prophecy, too. I was worried Calak might be planning on attacking Haizen. Yurio says, the Moonlight Witch's prophecies are only warnings. If you try hard enough, you can avoid the worst of it. Or all of it altogether. It's Bellart who's bad. I think he's trying to use the Moonlight Witch's prophecies to start a war between the North and the South. I understand. I'll dispatch Haizen forces to the fortress at Lake Rapinas. I'll have them rescue Queen Carrie. Chris says, no, don't do that. Huh? The people at the fortress aren't bad people. If you send in your fortress forces, they'll end up battling the fortress soldiers. Philly says, innocent people will be killed. Yuria says, yeah, that's not good. Isn't there any other way? Says Yuria. Yuria and friends thought about other ways with King Eneton. I know, says Chris. Yuria says, you scared me. I have a good idea. Yuria and I should sneak into the fortress. Yuria says, how? We'll think about that later. I think that's the hardest part. We'll get in somehow. Just listen. And then we'll secretly rescue Queen Carrie. How? We can think about that later, too. This really isn't a plan, you know. It's okay. While we're doing that, Philly will go back and contact King Calak. She can have him wait outside at the south side of the fortress. King Eneton will be at the north side. Once we rescue Queen Carrie, it's over. There's nothing scary about Bellart. We'll scream really loud, and that's when the two kings can show up. And what are the two kings going to do? There's only one thing they can do. They shake hands.
Shake hands?
Yeah. If the two kings shake hands like they're friends in front of all the soldiers, there'll be no mistake about it. That sounds like a good plan. See? The king says, as you say, if the soldiers meet each other, it may lead to war. Then we'll fall into Bellart's plans. But we can't expose you to danger. We have no other way, says Uriel. We'll be okay. I get the feeling this will work. I don't think the soldiers of the fortress would attack you, but if they are being manipulated by Bellart, we don't know what they'll do. They might even use their bows and arrows against you. Chris says, we'll be okay, King Eneton. We're good at running away. We're pretty fast at running. The first thing we'll do when we get inside the fortress will be to find the armory and destroy all their weapons. We can burn their bows and arrows. Oh boy, so destructive. The king says, that's a rather drastic strategy. Yo-Yo says, do you think so too, King Eneton? King Eneton nodded with a troubled look on his face. Yo-Yo says, but don't worry, it'll be successful. Yeah, this is the only way. Philly says, it's worth a try. At any rate, Bellart will probably use Queen Carrie as a shield when he starts something. The king says, I guess so. Philly makes it seem like this operation will succeed. This is a hard decision to make. Queen Pilia says, honey? Yes? It's your lack of decisiveness that lets Bellart have a shot at the throne by taking advantage of sibling issues. You're always wishy-washy. Can't you ever make a clear-cut decision like these people here? Shots fired. I'm sorry. By the way, I agree with these people. I think this operation may be dangerous, but it's more dangerous to bring in the forces when Queen Carrie is there. Okay. I'll make a decision one way or the other. Okay, I've made my decision. Let's do it. I will cooperate fully. I'll leave this operation all up to you. Chris says, it's been decided. Yurio says, okay, then let's hurry and head to the fortress at Lake Rupinas. Philly says, okay, then I'll leave for Heroku and tell King Calak. Okay. Sounds like we have our mission ahead of us. King says, I'll be waiting at the north side of the fortress. We'll go in once we get the signal. Don't do anything dangerous now. It'll be real trouble if something happens to you. And the queen. This man, Bellart, he plans on taking Queen Carrie as a hostage to control the southern half of Venthi by making King Calak a puppet. The king says, then he'll try to advance to north to take over all of Venthi. What a coward. Thinking about Queen Carrie trapped in the fortress makes my heart ache. I hope she gets rescued soon. Okay.